Democrats just declared war on the U.S. The Georgians hit our communications, transportation, power grids. We still don't know how extensive the damage is. Your mission just became critical. You know what you need to do.
Hey everybody, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play of Splinter Cell. I don't know why I wanted to do this game next. I just wanted to take a break from Assassin's Creed, and I just like rolled a dice on like some games that I was thinking, and Splinter Cell came up, and I was like, you know what? Why not? I've never beaten the first one. I've played through a lot of Chaos Theory, and I beat Double Agent way back when on the Xbox 360. That was a long time ago. But the first one always sort of eluded me, and I've never beaten it. I've played through parts of it, but I feel like I just want to go for it. So we're going to do this from the very beginning. I don't know all of the, I don't know all the weird stuff in this game. I don't know all the Easter eggs, but I'll try to find the ones that I do know about.
Canceled a trip to Georgia this morning after the suicide bomb assassination of that country's president by separatist rebels from the Abkhazia region. Continued fighting in the Abkhazia and South Ossetia regions has hindered Georgia's hopes of integration into Western institutions. Industry baron Kumbain Nikolad seized power today in a bloodless coup, installing himself in the presidential palace behind a wall of political and military support. The charismatic billionaire plans on holding elections within a matter of days to affirm his seat of power, and promises a pristine and profitable relationship with America and the West. Bringing high-speed fiber optic connectivity to areas of Eastern Europe that less than a decade past didn't have telephones. The technological leap is due largely to the efforts of rising information industries in the Netherlands, and especially Georgia, where the Vice President called his visit to Georgia an honor, and called Georgian President Kumbain Nikolad a man with his eyes on the future.
Yeah, so that's the backstory to all of this. Basically, there's somebody who's seized control in Georgia, pretty much, winning over the public and everything, but obviously there are going to be things that are not what they seem, because the political intrigue in this is very interesting. So, sorry about the small size of the video. I might increase it in post. I don't know whether I'm going to do that yet, but it's just that's the resolution of the pre-rendered videos, unfortunately. CIA training farm, Camp Perry, I thought. Virginia, August 7th, 2004. Wow, that's a long time ago. 6:01 hours. Prove that you are the right man for the job. As Agent Sam Fisher, you have been recruited to spearhead the operational arm of the National Security Agency's Third Echelon Initiative. Before being sent into the field, you must demonstrate that you possess the skills to undertake dangerous and covert solo missions. So, I do very much enjoy playing these games super stealthily, so we will try to do this as stealthy as possible. I'm not gonna run in, guns a-blazing most of the time. In fact, I remember as a kid, I like memorized parts of Chaos Theory to do
Sam
it as silent as possible.
I can't believe you beat me here.
I like to be early. Hello, Colonel.
You can use my name, the room's safe.
Lambert.
Good to see you again. I trust NSA orientation is going well?
Well enough. Everybody's been real coy about what exactly I'm allowed to know.
It's the nature of the agency. We don't let any one person know everything, which means we've all got to work together.
Even though I'll be out there alone.
You'll be transmitting to us in more ways than you can imagine. And we'll be online through your earpiece and OPSAT.
And that's how we're handling training.
Yep. Sorry to make you run the course. I know you've been taking care of yourself.
I haven't been in the field in years.
Sure. But tradecraft is something you don't forget. It's like riding a bike.
Or wearing high heels.
Be careful, Fisher. Everything we say is being monitored. You know how nervous the brass is about exercising the fifth freedom.
I'll be good.
Be better than good. Third Echelon is a brand new initiative. The role aggressive intelligence operations will play in NSA's future will depend largely on your performance. I'll see you on the far side of the course.
All right, Sam, let's get started. Can you hear me clearly?
Yes.
Hi there.
Good. That means the implanted speaker is working correctly. Now, the technicians here want to calibrate your equipment. Can you turn to the red emergency light on the wall to your left?
Uh-huh.
Great. Now the one on your right.
Okay.
Okay, same thing for pitch. Look for another light up in the rafters on the ceiling. Excellent. Now look for one on the ground in front of you.
All right, Fisher, we'll get through this as quickly as possible. We'll start simple. Climb up onto that ledge, over that pool.
All right, so this is the basic controls for Sam Fisher. I do need to check something real quick. Mission information settings. There's one thing I didn't see last time. Maybe they just don't have it. So the mouse sensitivity I could probably turn down a little bit. Yeah, do that. There's no run thing. Huh. Maybe I'm just going crazy. And unfortunately, there is no subtitles in this, sorry to say. We get up to here. Press jump shift at the base of the ledge to grab onto it. The shift is our jump. He automatically grabs. We move over here. And we can stand up.
We'll let you do your thing here. You're looking at your basic assault course. I'll chime back in once you've passed it.
Okay. Your default speed is walking. Use the accelerate key, mouse wheel up to increase Sam's speed. Oh, right. Okay, so we mouse wheel up to do that. And we can slow him down that way. I forgot about that. You can interact by pressing spacebar. And they give you little hints as to what you should be doing. So he can just move up ladders. They'll explain the little meters on our right in a bit, but I want to go up the zipline real quick. So we can get here. Climbing a vertical pipe is like using a ladder. Oh yeah, I forgot. You can't actually go around that edge. Trying to remember where the thing is that... Is it over here? Or is it at the other side? I think it's on the other side. There's a little Easter egg that we can find right in the training mission. Then we go over here. Crouch whenever you get near beams. Split jump. Ah. Hold on. The split jump is something that we gotta master there. This will be extremely useful, especially once we have a gun, because we can just stay up above corridors, and especially in a dark corridor, it'll be very useful. So we can either jump down onto an enemy, or just stay up there to avoid detection altogether. So once we get over here, we crouch to bring his legs up. We move a little bit slower, but helps avoid detection. You know, I'm really surprised. Like, I played all this on Xbox way back when, but, actually, very nicely ported. He'll climb over fences real easily. When we're up against the wall, you press Q. Or maybe when you're here. And then Q to get off. Oh. I forget, like, what direction it is. It's like, I don't know. It's a weird thing. Sam doesn't always go go the direction you think he's going to. Okay. So once we get here, they're going to teach us about the wall jump.
As soon as you can find a way over the gate, we'll move on to covert ops training.
So this is the one where they teach you the wall jump. Now, once we get here, door locked. Wait. But that's where we would go if we wanted to finish this. If we look right here, I think that's 56253. 514-56253. I think that's what we need. So now that we've got that, unfortunately, we have to go all the way back around. Because there's no easy way to do this. But I do want to show this off. Because I don't think many people know about this. Yeah, I don't think there's any way to get back there quicker, unfortunately. Oop! Yeah, we're fine. Sam can take a little bit of damage. I mean, he is old, but he's not gonna die. So if you go through the course backwards after finding that, I realize now that I could have just done it and then showed you where the thing was, but that's not giving us the full adventure, you know? Come on, Sam. Oh, come on. Get up. There we go. He needs to actually have enough space to lift his legs. He won't do it up against the wall. I mean, it's an interesting detail. I don't know if it's one I would have kept just for simplicity's sake. But whatever. It's not a big deal. Alright. Run around here. Get over here. We can climb up the pipe to get back to where we started. I know, right? The whole thing. Okay. So, if you come back to the area where you started after getting over there, you can... Oops. Jump up here. And there's a briefing and observation room. If you come to the side here, there's a little keypad. Was it 56523? No. What is the... No, I gotta look it up because I don't remember. Oh, okay. So. I'll probably cut all this later. You have to go to this side first. Go up here. Then when you get up here, you can open this door. And in here, the completely dark room, you can take a lockpick. And with this lockpick, I forgot about this step. Ugh. Okay, I'm going to cut to getting all the way back over there because we need to go through the entirety of the course. And go through that locked door that we saw. Alright, so once we get here, can't open this door, but... How do you do this again? We have the lockpick. Hold on. How do we use the lockpick again? Do I have to equip it? Well, good to know where that is. Alright, what's the controls? Back to wall, alternate fire, reload, interaction. Heat vision, night vision. Quick inventory control. So, now that we have the lockpick. Wait, how do I use the lockpick? Oh my god! This is important to know. Or do I just... Oh, okay. So, we can now pick this lock. I remember how... So you press up, down, left, or right, depending on the pin. Now that we have this open, we have a computer right here. There's a switch right there, so use the computer. And we have a note added from the data stick. So, there's that. We can also switch the light off. Now that we have that... Nope, not backpack. Where is it? Is it control? Yeah, okay. The code for the observation platform over the assault course is 5656. And I think there's a little extra bit of data. No? There's lockpick. Is that the only thing? I thought there was more on this. Nope, apparently not. So now that we've got that, we can head all the way back. So I'll see you guys back there. Alright, anyways, we come back here. Now we can use the keypad. 5656. That opens up this door. Now we can head inside here. And look at that. There's a person here.
Who are you?
You must be Sam Fisher. I'm Anne of Grimm's daughter. Pleased to meet you.
Third echelon lead programmer.
You've done your homework.
Some of it. I'm still a little foggy on my opsat.
The Operation Satellite Uplink. Basically just a multi-million tax dollar PDA. But it'll tally everything you'll need to know to complete your missions, so make sure you're comfortable with the interface. No need to introduce yourself. I've already got an earful of your history from Lambert.
I'm not as mean as he says.
On the contrary, the man thinks you should be canonized.
What? The saint of shady causes?
I don't know. How about the saint of well-directed sins?
You were involved with Second Echelon, right?
Yeah, briefly. I had some ideological differences.
Like what?
It didn't respect the human element.
Were you there for the burnout in 2000?
Yeah. But I don't even have clearance to think about it.
Anything else?
Good luck on the course. Good to meet you.
Yep. So that's pretty much it. You can also, if you want to...
Good to meet you.
Like, knock her out. But not advisable. You can also just leave her in the dark if you want. If you, knock her out, she, the course just ends and you fail the mission. Because it is technically still a mission. Alright. I could have sworn there was some way that we could look at data from the data stick, but... guess not? Oh, data stick. Why didn't that show up before? There we go. From Anna Grimm's daughter to Colonel Irving Lambert. Subject not likely. Lambert, I'm anxious to see what this super spy of yours can do, so I'll be watching for him from the observation platform over the assault course. I've temporarily changed the door code to 5656 to keep anybody from wandering in. If he's as capable as you say, I'm sure we'll do fine in the field. Just don't get too optimistic, old man. Just because the brass gave us the okay to recruit him doesn't mean that we're in the clear. We've still got a lot to prove here. And while Fisher may turn out to be the best thing since Audie Murphy, he's still just one man. A single slip up and the folks upstairs will shut us down faster than a leaking reactor. And as far as your claim that that there is no such thing as a secret when Sam Fisher is looking for something, well, I'll believe it when I see it. Well, I think you've got your super spy, considering that we actually made our way to Grimm. So yeah. Her, like, happiness in seeing you there, or not happiness, but, like, I guess the little bit of excitement is mostly due to the fact that, like, she didn't realize you would find her. She was never supposed to be found. And yet, you know, Sam is, quite talented, isn't he? Anyways, I'll see you guys back at the end of the course. Okay, over to the other side. Now we can finally proceed. No, they're watching us from here, too. No double pane glass for us this time.
We're going on into covert ops. The objective is to sneak through the area without being detected. We
You've got live bodies in there. Some of the top CIA instructors have kindly volunteered to be your victims.
Hmm. Okay. Alright, so. We've got, Yes, I know how to open the door. We've got to sneak through this next area here.
The next door is locked, Sam. You'll need to use your lockpicks to get through it.
Well, we already have the lockpicks. I guess you would be able to pick up lockpicks here if you didn't have them yet. But, see? Locked. So we're going to do this. You can press WASD until one of them works. And then you pick the door. Some locks are faster to pick than others.
This next door is keypad locked. The man guarding the door has the code to open it, but he's been instructed not to cooperate. Convince him otherwise.
So we can interrogate them. Let's interrogate the opponent. Actually, real quick. Oh, maybe I should have it show me that thing again. Just because I went... So spacebar to grab. If the character has any information, the interrogate interaction will appear. After you get the information you need, press fire left mouse to knock out and release your opponent. In later games, you can just straight up kill. We want to grab and then interrogate.
Hi there.
Hi.
You're not going easy on me, are you?
Not so tight. That hurts.
Sorry about that. What's the door code?
28469.
It was a pleasure working with you.
Likewise. 28469.
Okay. Good night. And we knock him out. 28469.
This next door is retinal scanner locked. These things are cheap and near impossible to hack. Fortunately, it's just a matter of getting the right eyes to the scanner, usually an officer. The gentleman ahead is registered for the scanner. Convince him to open the door for you.
Okay, same thing. You grab the person and the interaction key will appear when there is something that you can interact with. So we grab, move him over here. Use retinal scanner. And then we move him over to the shadows. And you can see that bar down in the lower right. Get smaller and smaller. That's our light meter. I'm sure it'll explain the light meter in just a bit, actually.
Let's work on stealth. Your gun should always be a last resort. Invisibility is your best weapon. We've got a network of photocells on your outfit connected to a visibility meter on your opsat. If the meter's at 4, you're lit up like a Dutch brothel. 0, you're a ghost's shadow.
Okay, so there's a camera at the end of the room. And you shoot the lights to get past the camera. So we're going to pull that out. But also what you can do. Wait for it to go across.
Agency trespasser.
Oh, come on.
I saw you on the monitor, Sam. Let's try that again.
Is it going to reset me? I'd love to, but I can't move. Oh, okay. So you shoot out the lights when you're in darkness, you can't be seen, and then you can just... Oh, you can't shoot that camera, never mind. Most of the time you can shoot the camera. So as you can see, Sam Fisher is not a great shot. Oh my god. Like, slightly under, actually. 2 to equip night vision goggles. and get to the end, and we open the door. Now, how do I put away the gun? Okay, it's E.
Some cameras are more fragile, and all you'll need to do to get past them is shoot them.
Ah, I see. This is the shooting camera. So, make yourself harder to see. You can get up on the door, or up on the wall. If we take off our night vision, you can see where we are. And we just kaboom! Shoot the camera. For some reason, I thought the other one was the one you could shoot.
Sometimes the only way to pass a camera will be to stick to existing shadows and time your movements.
Okay, don't get seen by the camera. Well, that's fine. We can do that.
Security cams have an intruder in the agency.
It wasn't even on me. It was all the way to the right.
On the monitor, Sam. Let's try.
Oh, horse poop. All right, reset me then. Hello? Okay. It was all the way right. I'll wait for it to go all the way right again.
Agency
what?
Trespasser on surveillance.
I saw you on the monitor. Let's try that again.
That's bull. It is bull. Alright, so I guess even if it's all the way right, it doesn't work. I guess you just gotta wait until it's all the way left and get behind that plank up against the wall.
Security
what?
Intruder in the agency.
Is there another one that I'm not seeing?
Monitor, Sam. Let's try that again.
Am I going crazy? Hold on. I'm like, I'm truly losing my mind. Okay, that time it worked. I don't know.
Knock out the guard in the corridor and hide his body before the patrolling guard finds it.
Okay.
We heard you, Sam.
Oh. I was moving too fast. So, this is what I usually do. I usually grab and pull them over here because
ow. Okay, now Fisher, let's bring in another guard to evaluate your work.
And just wait for him. Oh, they took away our gun. He'll move through. This guy's unconscious in the dark.
Got it.
And then he leaves.
Good work, Sam. Remember that discretion is critical to our operations. Covering up the evidence of your passing through will go a long way towards proving our usefulness in the field.
So that's part of the game, like, not having bodies be discovered will lead to a better score in the end. So you definitely want that to happen. Or don't want it to happen. You don't want them to discover things.
The next hallway's the same idea, but for sound. I'll be monitoring a few hidden mics.
Yep. So crouch. Move quietly. Move slowly. You can make some noise, but the more noise you make, the worse things are. So Avoid the chains. Go across this. There's glass here, which you can't avoid. You just gotta be careful.
Have you started yet? Fisher! Holy Christmas, you're at the end. Phenomenal work. Let's move on.
Yep. So the one thing I do miss from the other games is that they do add like a sound bar from the other games. Or maybe there's supposed to be a sound bar here and it's just not available yet. I don't know. Or maybe it's not showing.
Gotta be him.
Yep. Sam Fisher, let me introduce you to Vernon Wilkes Jr.
Hello.
Hey, I've heard crazy things about your work.
I hope you don't mind. I told him some of your stories from Kuwait.
We're all friends here.
Right on.
Junior Wilkes is a longtime NSA employee. He'll be your wheels, wings, and weapons. He coordinates transportation and equipment.
Great.
For sure. Man, you must be itching to get back out in the field, huh?
That's all I'm good at.
Well, it's all we need. Welcome to the NSA.
I'm sure things are going to come together famously. Third Echelon is a brand new initiative, and we're going to have a lot to prove.
Right.
The two of you will be Third Echelon's first team on the ground. Be ready for it, and do us proud. Welcome to the NSA.
And there we go. Mission complete. Or the first one, anyway. The training mission. But now starts the real game, because the next level, we're going to go into an actual thing. CRA training farm. Congratulations, Fisher. You have demonstrated that you are the right man to spearhead the NSA's Third Echelon initiative. The onus will be on you to prove that the worth of deploying solo cover operatives by gathering intelligence in the field and taking deliberate action based on that intelligence. Welcome to the NSA. No pressure.
This is going to sting.
Go ahead.
Hold that.
Christ, this is spooky.
What's that?
Grim sticking wires in your head, man.
I just need to sync the encryption signature between his subdermals and Fort Meade.
Don't like that.
I know. It's for after we land. You better hurry up, Grim. We touch down in Georgia in 15.
I'm already done. Lambert? Hey, Irving, do you read me?
Tell her I read her.
He reads you.
Good. You ready to get to work?
I'd feel better if I knew what was going on.
You know what you need to. The CIA lost a mole inside Georgian President Kombe Nikolaidze's cabinet. Her name is Alice Madison. They sent in Agent William Robert Blaustein to find her and lost him too.
Are we working with the CIA's cooperation?
Blaustein is outfitted with subdermals just like yours. That'll be your best lead to find him.
You didn't answer my question.
We'll tell you what you need to know. You're not out there alone, Fisher. Through me, you're attached to a dozen of the best NSA minds we have. There are political complexities with Georgia you'd need a week to understand.
I've just about memorized this speech, Lambert.
Well, start believing it. This is Third Echelon's maiden voyage, and we need it to go smooth as butter. You're about to touch down in Georgia. Get ready.
All right. Tbilisi, Old Town, Georgia. Locate CIA agents Blaustein and Madison. Agent Allison Madison worked covertly in the Georgian political arena for 2 years, securing a role in the President Nikolaidze? I don't know. Cabinet after his coup d'etat. She vanished on October 3rd. On October 7th, Special Agent Robert Blaustein was sent in to find her. He vanished on October 11th. Ooh, that's not good.
Fisher, the sun's down. Time to go to work. Finding Agent Blaustein's our first priority. You're to locate him through a local NSA contact.
I'm on my way.
And stay off the streets. There's a heavy cop presence in this town. We don't have Washington's backing if this turns into an incident. Details on your OPSAT.
So yeah, we're kind of on our own. Again, I'm going to try and be going through this all very stealthily. Let me make a save right at the beginning here. Oh. moving through. You don't have to be super slow here. I mean, nothing's really going to see you at the very beginning of the game. How do you get up there? Oh, right, there's a pipe. I was like, what? Well, that's not good.
Don't tell me. Gurgenidze is inside there.
Why would I tell you what you already know? You're going to have to hurry. Grimm's daughter's comparing a Dark Star drone sonar to the warehouse blueprints. She'll be guiding you through.
Sam, Grimm's daughter here. I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it. Get to this spot. There's a room directly across the hall. Go there now. Damn, sorry about that. Get back into the hall and go to the stairwell at the far end. Make it fast. You've only got a few seconds.
Uh-huh. Well, she told us to jump. We did it. And, well, you know, everything fell apart, so... Whoops-a-daisy. So we're gonna quickly go across to the other side.
Jesus, but that was close. Take a left just ahead and cut through the room. You'll find a stairwell on the opposite corner. Take it to the top floor.
Alright. Taking this to the top floor.
The contact is in this room. Let's hope to God he's still alive.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. I'm NSA. We're gonna get you out of here.
Don't bother. I'm as good as dead. You're looking for Blaustein and Madison.
Yeah.
Madison was deep into Nicolás's cabinet. She was onto something big. Blaustein must have figured it out.
How do I find him?
Blaustein's black box, the tracking relay for his subdermals. It's stashed in his safe house just east of Moravia Square.
Lambert, do we have resources to evac this guy?
I said don't bother. Whatever Madison found, it's big. She kept saying proof would mean war. I think Nicolás wanted... Oh.
Gurgenidze checked out.
Leave the corpse for the fire. Maybe less to explain to his family.
You've got a safe exit on the west side of the room. Take it.
Do we?
There's too much smoke. Shoot out the skylights.
So we shot out the skylight. It'll clear up a little bit. Let's us go through right here. And there we go.
It was pretty tight. You still breathing?
Doing my best.
Good. Blaustein's black box is your next objective. If he's running standard agency tradecraft, you'll find the box behind a fake bookshelf or roll panel.
Okay, now we're basically on our own here. There are civilians. You don't want to get their attention. Thankfully, civilians aren't really looking your way most of the time. So, you don't have to worry about it too much. That was almost a close call.
Put Gringo on, because those are my orders. I speak to Vyacheslav Gringo or nobody. As Gringo, hey, sir, this is Ketevan. We finished searching the American's apartment. There is nothing else there. If 5 more bugs, 2 cameras, and some electronics we can't ID. They are already on their way to the ministry. Of course. Thank you, sir.
Well, okie dokie then. So, it's a little bit dangerous of an area right here. I'm going to make a save. Things could go bad very quickly here. I'm going to save on top of that. No, I can't save on top of that. So I believe if we just wait, actually, they'll leave. Because there's a dude searching in there. Oh, what the what? Why did he turn around? What the what? Or did he turn around at the exact moment that I went over to him? See if we can grab him. But here's the problem. Even if you knock him out, there's not a lot of place to put him. Especially because you can't throw him, like, over there. Which is unfortunate.
Who is that?
Frickin'. Gun's not working. It's okay, nobody will really know.
How the hell?
So he'll come and investigate. We can grab him. Because why not? Unfortunately, he doesn't have anything for us. Sadly. And then we come up here. Now, you could try and go through the door. But we're just going to go through here. So let's use the computer. Anything on there? One note added from the data stick. What's the object? Oh, right. You can pick up, like, bottles and stuff. But I forget where they are. I do believe there is another guy in here. Or maybe that was the guy from downstairs. I don't remember. Darkness is our friend. So we, of course, turn off lights when we can. Nothing in here. We will use this med kit real quick. And, lo and behold, secret computer.
Dang! What's the news?
Blaustein's heart stopped beating 43 hours ago.
Any reason the CIA wouldn't know about this?
Nope.
Nice of them to share.
The subdermal went offline 6 hours after he died. The last active position was in a police station a few blocks away. Check your OPSAT.
So he's dead. That's nice. So Blaustein's balcony is 091772. Also, we get maps. There's data sticks. So, Mr. Sutton, I think we could stop dancing around words. Agent Madison is dead. Our only real question is why, or more importantly, why Nicoladze thought you could hide it from us. Your theory about her disappearance as a way to keep the secret connections between Georgian politics and Russian mafia works, but it's too easy. It wouldn't justify murdering a U.S. agent. And Nicoladze knows we know how dirty he is. I think I'm being followed, though it's hard to separate paranoia from reason in this part of the world. I suggest we start swapping digital signatures more often, maybe twice a week. Forward Gergen Z, this keypad code for the back door. I'll expect pickup by 10 a.m. Say happy birthday to Kay for me. I'll be back in VA for the next one. Ooh. BB got the following from her man, Gergen Dinzi. I've got the envelope, thank you very much, and I'll have the police station information in our dead drop behind the bushes in Morovia Square. Ooh. The drop behind the bushes in Morovi Square. I'm sure it'll be there. Tom's a trustworthy type. If I can safely make the drop, I may leave you a toy or two. Walk safe. But there is a dead drop as well. Oops. Good to know. What was it? Oh wait, it's under notes. 091772. 091772. So it's always a good idea to go for computers and the like. Never a reason not to, in my opinion. Alright. So here's weirdly, like, one of the hardest parts of this entire level.
Hello? Who's there?
No one? Because all of these frickin' civilians are so curious about, like, everything. It's insane. I forget what's down here. Is there a reason to come up here? I think this is just death, isn't it? It is not. Oh. Oh no, I think this is the way you're supposed to go.
Fisher, I'm rescinding my street level restriction. We've been monitoring the Tbilisi police radio. These cops are as crooked as a Virginia fence. They're not going to want any more international attention than we do. Every road is open to you. Do what you gotta do to find those missing spooks.
Okay. Dang lights you can't destroy. They're the worst kind. Door locked. Okay, well. What we use the lockpick for. A pretty heavy lock. Okay. And we can use our other little toy. Optical cable just to see what's on the other side. Looks like it's pretty safe.
What do you think you're doing? Prison cells don't come cheap these days.
The real estate is closer to your rent in the morgue.
Slabs are going for cheap.
Yeah, I think we could set you up with this slab real easy.
I've done nothing. Please.
Nothing? How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
You said we're associated with criminals.
Then arrest me. I must sleep.
Weren't you listening?
The rent's gone up in jail.
You want to die tonight? That's free. You want to sleep tonight, it'll cost you 100 lari.
Oh, please, I don't.
Now what are we going to do with him?
Check his pockets. I'll radio HQ.
Sure.
Unit 3 to dispatch. We have a 1053, possible assault. Can you send an ambulance?
Copy that, Unit 3, but we're dealing with a warehouse fire, so expect delay.
Roger that, dispatch. We'll wait with the victim. Unit 3,
who's there?
Oops. Well, I'll take this object. They'll come down and check that out. Ay, ay, ay. There's like... Oh, okay. Hello? Leave.
Maybe it's better if I didn't see anything.
Yeah, it is. Okay, I think they're... Maybe it's this way?
I heard something. Go on out where I can see you.
Dang it. There is a way to, like, get up on that railing. But I don't remember what it is. As you can see, we're gonna take the long way around some of these things.
It's probably not my problem. Maybe it's better if I didn't see anything.
Really? That's right, go on the other side of the thing. I could have sworn there was a way to get up here, but I guess not. And then that guy becomes a problem. Because he can sometimes see you if you're in the wrong spot. Thankfully, I think we're in a good spot right now that he won't actually see us. So where was the location that... Or maybe I just... How do I toss this? There is a way to toss objects, but I don't remember what the controls are. Use equip. Quick inventory. Oh, there it is. Okay, so we're gonna... Basically, we're gonna toss this... Over there.
Who's there?
No one, you can't see me. And they're gonna go over there and check that out. Dang it, they both should have gone. That's fine. We'll just do this the hard way then. Which is to grab them one at a time. Although I think if you can do this with like the least amount of interaction, you get a better score.
What the hell?
Who knows what that was? Go check it out. Why are you coming to me? Hold on. That's bull. Oh, wow. All right. Well, let's do this again, I guess. The normal way. Ugh. So annoying. Okay, so. Got one guy down.
I think I heard something.
Have that guy explore. Stay a little far away so that he doesn't come over to us. Why is he coming over to us? Why are you coming over to us? It doesn't matter. That's weird. Now we just knock out this dude. And we're all safe. But now... We gotta wait for that guy to move out of the way. There are quite a few bottles that we could use if we wanted to throw those at him. Cause distractions. There's a guy above us. Which means that shooting out that light is kind of a poor decision. And unfortunately, he just walks back and forth here. We haven't seen it yet. But there is a guy. Yep, there he is. And walks across there and looks down the alleyway. So our first order of business is going to be to take out the guard that walks along this street and patrols here. It is a slow process, but if you want to do this silently, this is kind of what you got to do. Unfortunately, there's no way to take out the guy above us. So we're just going to have to do that silently. So there is a way to get up here from, like, down below. I just don't remember what it is. Yeah, definitely not a, what the fuck? What the what? What the what? I'm going insane. I'm actually going insane. Okay, so, we're just gonna sneak past him. Honestly, probably better. You could shoot out the lights, but again, there's people walking around over here. So you've got to watch for that guy who appears in the window. The guy in the window really throws a wrench in a lot of plans. Also, that guy's a problem.
Is something moving over there?
Enemy on sight!
What the
You're good at-
Why is he seeing me? This is insane! Oh, because the light, for some reason, right there, jumps up. Yeah, right there, it jumps up. Past the first bar. Basically, enemies will see you if you're in anything but the lowest bar. I don't understand. I mean, maybe I'm just, like, remembering Chaos Theory being way, way better about the monitoring and, being able to let you know how much light is actually on you.
Clear non-essential personnel from all secure areas and report back to control.
Well, we're just gonna grab him then. And we're far enough away that that guy's not gonna notice. So that's nice. Pick up this bottle. Makes a couple of things a little easier. There's that guy over there. Alright, we're gonna make another save. Yeah, we're gonna make a lot of saves. Which way are you facing?
You're not supposed to be here.
Apparently he saw me. But he was a civilian, so doesn't actually matter. Civilians are just annoying. I'll be totally honest. We go up here pretty quickly because we don't want to be seen by the guy from behind. Alright. This brings us into this courtyard area. Which there's a dude over there. I believe there are people over there that show up every now and then. For whatever reason. Okay. So, I believe he said in the plaza, his dead drop is over here in the corner. And there it is. Pick up the other medical kit. Because why not? Pick up both of them. Use the computer. We got a data stick. So what does that say? Door code for the precinct basement is 5929. Okay. And the third data stick says William Tannehill. Got the following from our man Gurgundy's. I got the envelope, thank you very much. I'll have the police station information and our dead drop behind the bushes in Morovi Square. Oh no, that's the one that we've already read. Is it this one? You can be getting into the police station with the keypad combination of 5929. This way goes by the back way to the holding cells. You're best for go at night when the drunks are all passed out. Good to know. And now, there are cops that have spawned here. Because why not? We want to stay in the dark, of course. But now we can go through there. I think the real problem with this area has become that there is a person that's over there sometimes. It is an officer walking around here, isn't it? I don't think we can get anything from him, unfortunately. He'll come over here in just a moment. I guess I don't technically need to grab him, but... eh. Unless he sees me right here. No reason not to.
Who's there?
What the what? What is going on? Oh god, where was 1E? Oh. Balls.
What the? Oh my god. Who is? You're not supposed to be here.
Oh, they're both civilians. Alright. Oh god. This is just a poor performance all around. Maybe I'll do better in the next episode. Maybe that's what we need to do. Maybe we just need to take a little break and come back to this. I was so much better at this game before. Oh, Lord. Maybe I just gotta get back into the groove of it. Or maybe Chaos Theory really did spoil me with how good it works. Anyways. Thank you all for watching. I think we're just gonna end it here. Bye-bye!